Hi guys, today I'm going to talk about the S22 Ultra's photo options and the different settings a little deeper inside the phone. There are some stuff there you might want to enable or disable. By the way, my name is Chris, or Christopher if you're new on my channel. Take a look around and hopefully you want to subscribe. That's all up to you. And another thing, my community tab has been enabled by YouTube, so hopefully you want to interact with me there. I'm going to try to upload a more private stuff there, behind the scenes and things like that, pictures. I'm going to find it out along the way. It's new to me, so we will see how that develops. Okay, let's jump into the phone before I keep going like this. If you've seen my other videos, I'm good at that. Let's jump in. Here we are inside the Samsung S22 Ultra's native app, and we can start with the Pro. And as you can see on the left side of it, you have different options. All of these you can change to auto or manual settings. So you can see here, if you push it, you get manual or auto option on the right side there. So if you push that one, you can do auto or manual. You have ISO, and ISO is very important to try to keep as low as possible when you are doing your photography. The higher ISO, the more grain and noise you introduce to the photo that you are taking. The way you control the light in this phone is using the speed, or if you have an ND filter, but I haven't seen anybody make a cover and an ND filter that fits the S22 Ultra yet. Hopefully it will come in the future. So until then, use the speed as your main light controller when you are taking photos. Exposure value, just keep it like that. Focus auto, keep it like that. And white balance, keep it like that. Of course, you want to play around, do that, but the autofocus is quite good on the S22 Ultra. On the left side here, you have color tone. You can play around with the contrast and different things there. But if you do editing in Lightroom or Photoshop, it's a waste of time. Under there, we have metering modes. You have, if you push that one, it says up here, matrix metering. And spot metering and center weighted metering. So you can play around and see what you like when you are doing your photos. Under there you have the ratios. You have full, 1:1, 16:9 and 4:3. And of course this one, you can lock the autofocus and auto exposure where you like on the frame. So if I want to go over here, I can push that and the lighting conditions changes to the point where I set this one. And then you can lock it and it won't change if suddenly a cloud or something comes in front of the sun or something like that. So locking the exposure can be smart. Under there you have the timer, 10, 5, 2 and none. Under there you have the flash, and under there you have the settings. So if we go into the settings, we can go down to something that I think is important to enable, is raw copies. If you enable that one, it saves both JPEG and raw copies of the picture, and the information in the raw copies is much more than if you do a JPEG. A JPEG is a compressed photo, and it's not much you can do in an editing software if you are trying to edit a JPEG picture. So enable raw copies to put that picture inside the Photoshop or Lightroom and have a lot of more information in that picture to play around with to make your own creative output. A little further down here we have grid lines. Grid lines, enable that one, and as you can see here you have lines on the screen, and there are rules when it comes to videography and photography that these grid lines can help you get. So read up on grid lines or composition rules and stuff like that, and you can you will understand that grid lines can be useful to have enabled. Okay, so let's jump to next one. You have a little here up here. You can push. It's the, I don't remember the name, but it shows the highs and the lows on the photo as you turn the camera. But I'm setting it on tripod now, so I'm not gonna readjust it. But you have this one if you wanna use that as a measuring point in your photo. Here we are inside the portrait mode, and we're not gonna go into the left side here much. Up here we can move its effects, and if you push that, you will have skin smoothness option here. But if you do the skin smoothness, it gets really fake, so I wouldn't touch that at all. Here we have times one or times three when you wanna do your portrait. And if we go up here on the top side here, you can see that if you push that, you will get a lot of options or effects. You have the blurry background, and you have studio, you have high key mono, and you have low key mono, and you have backdrop, and you have color point. On each option here, you can adjust the effect of the option here, and create your own style on the options. If we go to photo, then you can see that we have lost the manual and auto options here, but we have a lot of more options here. Times 0.6, times 1, times 3, times 10, and times 30, and times 100. I readjusted the camera a little, and as you can see all the way over there, there is a little point, and we're gonna try to zoom into it and see how the quality of the zoom is. But as you can see, let's see, now that's 0.6 times 1 times 3 times 10, and then we have to readjust. Like that. And now we're gonna try go a little further. Times 30. And as you can see, the wind is taking the tripod, so it's very much vibration in it. But that's why I'm not using this, because I don't see the point in this. This is times 30, and we have the times 100. So now we have to readjust again on the tripod. Let's see if we can find that spot. You have a visual on the left side of the phone. It says it's centered there, but you can see there, that's how it looks like. And if we go back to the wide, that's the distance, and that's times 100. So the quality is not too good, but as you can see, it's very windy. If it was 100% still, maybe the quality would be a little better, but it's quite a difference. It's a big distance. And then we go 30, not too bad, but as you can see, the more we zoom in, the more the vibration is noticeable. So the wider we go, the less noticeable the vibration is. So that's why it's good to have a wide angle when you're filming and taking photos. So you can see here, it's quite a nice scenery today. So I'm just gonna take a picture of it. Yeah, on the left side here, you have much the same. You have some filters, face, off or on. I wouldn't play around with that at all, but that's me. And then you have the motion photos. If you take a photo, it also can be a little motion in it. It's just a little play setting option, in my opinion. the ratio, timer, flash, and the settings that we have been inside looking at. If we go to the pro version of this, super telephoto, you see the vibration, very noticeable. Go telephoto, wide, and ultra wide. See, it's very dark now, so we have to use this one and try to adjust it a little. But I have enabled RAW, so if it's a little dark now, it doesn't have to be too bad, because I can get that information back in the post edit in Lightroom or in the Photoshop. So that's my advice to you. Just play around, underexpose, overexpose, learn how the different things affect the photo. If you underexpose, you can get some information back, but if you overexpose the picture like this, this is blown out, so you can't get that back in post edit. But a little dark you can get. So my advice to you when you do photography, try to not blow out the whites. Try to keep the whites fairly, something like that. Take the photo, have a raw copy, go into post edit and get the other stuff around here back in the photo. So let's go to more. Here we have a few other options. We have food. You can see it's blurry around. You can take that off by pushing that one, and you can activate it by pushing it. Settings, ratio 16:9, and temperature of the picture. But I wouldn't mess with it, because the phone is actually quite good at finding good temperature. And if you are editing again in software, Photoshop, Lightroom, or others, you don't want to mess too much with that, because you're going to do that in the editing software. So we have to go back out and back into more. You have panorama and you have night. The night mode is very simple, but it has extra focus on getting a good quality in bad light conditions. So if we go back again to more, we go to panorama. You can see it's 0.6 or zoom 1. That's it. And you slide to the left or you slide to the right to make the panorama photo. That was it. That was the native app that S22 Ultra has. Some settings, some photo options. So now you know a little, so you can try to explore the phone and find your own creative way to make use of the different photo options in the phone. There is another app called Expert RAW. I'm gonna make another video about that later on. But now I wanna get home. It's freezing cold. Almost like I wasn't sure that I was going to make it, but I'm going home now, and think I have to do some flapjacks and OL-fluken, that we call it in Norwegian, to get the blood out in the arms again, because it was biting cold today. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed some of it, and if you want to, I would appreciate if you subscribed, maybe share the video, and make a comment if you want to. Check out my other videos, and I see you next time. Bye bye. Oh, fuck a duck.